So the new DJI Mini 2. I think this is the best drone for the beginners, but it might be a little bit difficult at first when you're just starting out, because you get inspired, you see beautiful video on the internet, you go outside, try to film the same way, and your video does not quite look at the same level. Well, first things first, try to always shoot in 4K because this is the highest resolution possible on the Mini 2. And when shooting in 4K, your image looks more crispy, it looks more sharper. If you downgrade to 1080 and then also upload to YouTube, well, this video will be compressed by YouTube as well, by the drone, by your editing software. So try to always stick to 4K unless you really need the slow motion, which is also possible to shoot on the Mini 2. But I would strongly suggest you to stick to 4K. Second, try to avoid overexposing or underexposing your image, because if you underexpose, well, then you will not be able to recover all the information and your video will be either too grainy, too noisy, or without any details, too contrast in the image. It's not good. Well, let's say right now I can easily recover the shadows in my image or the highlights without any problems. Well, that's not the case with the Mini due to this small tiny sensor. This is not possible. And in regards to overexposing the image, there is a really useful tool in the DJI Mimo app. Well, all you have to do is turn on your Zebras overexposure warning, and then whenever you have too bright image at the point where you're losing all the details in the frame, well, the app will color all these areas in the image with the zebras. That means there is no information in your video. So this is really useful. Always turn on your zebras on any cameras. Tip number three, if you like the slow movement of the camera, if you like how the drone orbits around something, or when you have a cool reveal in the frame, well then try to adjust your gimbal sensitivity. Go to the settings, click here, go to advanced gimbal setting, and then you can select your desired gimbal speed at which your gimbal goes up and down, and also you can adjust the sensitivity at which the gimbal stops the movement, breaks the movement when you don't rotate the wheel. So this really helps to achieve the smooth movement when you tilt the camera up or down. This is one of the most important settings in my opinion. Whenever I'm flying a drone, whether it's Mavic 2 Pro, Mavic Zoom, any drone, I'm always going first to adjust the gimbal sensitivity in order to make sure that I'm having the smoothest image possible. Also, if you go to YouTube and you see other drone videos and you notice how silky smooth the water looks, how all the movements, all the details look really, really nice, the secret to it is that the drone pilots probably have motion blur in their image, and it's easily achievable if you have 180 degree rule in your frame. So just set up your frames per second. Let's say you're shooting at 25 frames per second. That means your shutter speed has to be 1/50th of a second. In that case, you'll have a beautiful motion blur. But there is a catch here. Sometimes it's difficult to set your shutter speed at 1/50th of a second, let's say, if you're shooting outdoors during the bright day, because your image will be overexposed, all covered with zebras, as you see. Well, in that case, you need something like ND filters for your drone. They are the best in the market right now, best quality glass, and they're also very lightweight, so your drone is still under 249 grams, which is really important while maintaining the best quality image. All the links in the description to the filters. Sometimes it's useful to shoot with manual balance whenever your lighting conditions change dramatically and fast, but most of the time I would suggest you to shoot with the auto white balance. Sometimes auto white balance is pretty good. Let's say even right now I'm shooting on the cinema camera with auto white balance, and I think it's decent. What do you think, guys? I think it's pretty good. Because sometimes beginners make a mistake, they shoot first at manual white balance, then the next day they go shoot again and they forget to change it, and it's really difficult on a drone like Mavic Mini or Mini 2 to fix it in post. So I would recommend you to stick to auto white balance. And a bonus tip for you guys, if you live as I am right now in cold conditions, your phone tend to discharge, lose the battery power really quickly. So there is actually an option in your drone remote controller to charge your phone while being connected to the remote. So this can save some of the cool frames, as it did with me when I shot this video with DJI. I always want to say Mavic 2, DJI Mini 2. All right, this is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Do not forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel. See you next time. Bye-bye.